What's cracking, Hayward? This is the A&E Beat. I'm Eric Green.
And I'm Kathleen Gutierrez.
If you were lucky enough to witness The Dark Knight in theaters this summer, then you too must have fallen from your seat in shocking awe as Christian Bale appeared on the IMAX screen as John Connor in the long-awaited post-apocalyptic film Terminator Salvation.
I knew it was coming. But this is not the future my mother warned me about. And in this future, I don't know if we can win this war. This is young Connor.
Set in the not-so-distant 2018, Connor has grown up to witness his mother's apocalyptic prophecies come true as the self-aware supercomputer system Skynet has taken over and Judgment Day has finally taken place.
What were your thoughts on Senator McCain's debate performance Wednesday?
You know, I just thought he was great because the American people are angry and John McCain is angry too.
On October 19th, Saturday Night Live enjoyed its highest watched show in 14 years thanks to Tina Fey's Sarah Palin impression.
What? The real one?
Bye!
As the fake Palin was warned about the real Palin's entrance, she darted off stage before the two were able to face off, leaving some real sense of tension in the air.
Hit the stopwatch. Someone please tell Joe the plumber's 15 minutes of fame are up. According to Politico.com, Joe the plumber, aka Samuel Wurzelbacher, has hired a Nashville-based publicist firm in an attempt to extend those 15 minutes into a bona fide country record deal. Joe sparked a controversy when he said an Obama presidency would bring death to Israel.
That one comment, a vote for Obama is a vote for the death to Israel. I'll guarantee you that.
Well, you know what? Actually, I'll go ahead and agree with you on that one. No, I agree with you. I really think that would be a problem.
Rep Delacroce says of Joe the plumber, he's a complicated guy with a very dynamic personality. Delacroce told Politico, he can sing and obviously has a strong political point of view.
If you're into Oscar-quality flicks like The Pianist and When Harry Met Sally, then Zach and Mary Make Porno is definitely not the joint for you. Conversely, if you like The Office, Knocked Up, or Superbad, this is definitely the movie for you. Seth Rogen, The Office's Craig Robinson, and Elizabeth Banks star in this laugh-out-loud comedy that was nearly rated NC-17.
Star Wars.
What? Han Solo ain't never had no sex with Princess Leia in the Star Wars.
I'm gonna be honest, my first time. I'm not gonna touch you, nothing like that. I have a wife, we're happy. I mean, not happy, but it's cool. It's my job as the producer to see what you got that makes you uncomfortable. I love the movies. Sugar.
Does she have a talent?
It's a little. After finding out her former crush has been dating a gay porn star, Mary is crushed, and after getting their utility shut off, broke roommates Zach and Mary decide to make porno. Zach and Mary open Halloween night and runs throughout Thanksgiving.
Yeah. I just can't
believe. Breaking news in the Jenniffer Hudson triple homicide case, as Chicago police have found the murder weapon used to kill Hudson's mother, 7-year-old nephew, and brother, who had to be identified by the Oscar-winning actress Friday, October 24, 2008. Two of the victims were found shot dead by Chicago police inside of Hudson's home, while days later, the 7-year-old boy was found shot dead in the back of a stolen white sports utility vehicle. Consequently, the only suspect in Hudson's former brother-in-law, William Balfour, was in custody before the boy's body was discovered.
On September 12th, 46-year-old American-born author and California professor David Foster Wallace was found dead in his backyard. Prior to killing himself, Wallace wrapped his wrist with duct tape in order to prevent any survival urges once he kicked the shaky chair from under his legs. The autopsy report states that Wallace nailed a belt to a wooden patio roof and that there was a lawn chair that was knocked over on its side next to the deceased. Wallace was under psychiatric care and had contact with a psychiatrist 2 weeks prior to his suicide. He is said to have undergone 12 electric shock therapy treatments. Known for his writings and essays, Wallace was most celebrated for his 1996 novel, Infinite Jest, which was chosen by Time magazine to be in its all-time 100 greatest novels from 1923 to 2006.
That's it for this week on The Beat. I'm Eric Green.
And I'm Kathleen Gutierrez.
Keep it real, Hayward.